Coming up, we take a look at how Azure Serverless offerings allow you to build and deploy elastic-scale, cost-efficient apps on Azure. We'll show you how adopting a serverless compute approach removes the need to worry about hardware resources and the operational complexity of running applications, the event-driven model for triggering compute power that allows you to just pay for what you use, and we'll walk through a serverless app for social analytics. Joined by Jeff Holland from the Azure Serverless Compute team. Welcome.
I'm thrilled to be here.
So serverless computing seems to have picked up a lot of momentum over the last year, but what is it and why has it come about?
Yeah, so it's a response to a number of things, but mainly it's around removing traditional barriers and building and deploying software to solve business needs. Traditional apps are designed to conform to the infrastructure they run on. Serverless apps offer an app-first model by abstracting away the infrastructure to relieve the developer from the operational complexity of running applications. The infrastructure only fires up when it needs to. It's serverless because you no longer have to worry about servers, virtual machines, patching, scaling, all those pieces that traditionally you have to manage and take time away from creating solutions. With serverless, you simply define your code or the steps that need to happen, publish it to Azure, and the rest is automatically taken care of for you. This means you can build and deploy cloud-scale applications in a fraction of the time.
Now, what you just described sounds a lot like PaaS, but how does this differ from platform as a service?
Yeah, so with PaaS, you still have to choose your operating system and the VM size, which means you need to be able to forecast your demand and then pay for that capacity, even if it's not fully utilized.
So how does this actually work in Azure?
With serverless, Azure has compute resources ready to be allocated to you. Their usage is triggered by an event. You give us your code, and when an event happens, this could be an Azure alert or when a message is received, whatever you specify, we spin up the necessary compute resources, and it's activity-based billing, so you only pay for when you're using the resources.
So can you give us an example and explain the serverless tech architecture behind this?
Sure. If I have a website and people want to upload pictures, let's say I need to resize those pictures. So whenever someone uploads a picture, I want to automatically resize it. Well, the upload is the event, and that's where Azure Functions come in. It contains and runs your code to resize the picture, and it has a series of bindings that attach to the event you want to listen to. So in this case, it listens for an upload and automatically resizes the image.
So I'm a developer. I've got my chunk of code. I give it to Azure Functions and it executes.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
But what if I need my code to perform multiple tasks? So if we stick with our photo example, so resize, compress, create a thumbnail, and then upload it to a store.
Yeah, so each one of those individual tasks would be an Azure function. And to orchestrate these different tasks, I would use Azure Logic Apps to build a workflow. So in our example, the different tasks from resizing, compressing, creating a thumbnail, displaying it in the store, those would be executed on an uploaded picture. And once all these tasks are done, I could make the next step to store the picture in OneDrive or my chosen cloud storage. And what's great is that most of the time, I don't even need to write the code for the orchestration or to integrate with apps like OneDrive because Azure Logic Apps has pre-built connectors.
So developers can just focus on their blocks of code and they can utilize these connectors to integrate with their existing systems.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm showing here, there's over 150 connectors provided by Logic Apps today. And this allows me to easily bind my serverless app to listen to events from sources like Dynamics or Salesforce. And I can also very easily create or push data into any of these sources.
Now, a lot of these connectors and what they connect to, they'll be familiar to IT. So it's important that both IT and developers work closely to integrate these in a way that's right for the business.
Right. In fact, a lot of the value that IT finds in systems like Logic Apps is that it allows them to very easily integrate those apps that their devs are building with the systems that they manage.
So it sounds powerful, but can we see it in action?
Sure. So I'll walk you through now the tools needed to build a serverless app. And in actually just a few minutes, we'll actually have something pretty powerful up and running. So in our case, we're going to listen to a data source, which is Twitter. We're going to be listening for different tweets. So maybe there's a conference or a launch that you are interested in understanding more about. So as tweets come in, we'll analyze them and publish them into a Power BI dashboard all in real time. So I'm here in the Azure portal, and this is the start of our app. And we're going to use that serverless workflow, Logic Apps, to start building our serverless app. So you'll notice here I've already added the event, which is when a tweet is posted. And in this case, I'm actually listening to tweets about Microsoft. Now, I can start to add in actions and resources to spin up when this event happens. So I'll go ahead here and add a step. And you'll notice those connectors we referenced earlier. And here I'm actually going to choose the text analytics connector, which uses machine learning as part of the cognitive services to actually do advanced things like detect the sentiment or pull out key phrases. So within just a few clicks, I could pass in the tweet text. And now just that easily, I've added machine learning into my serverless workflow. So at this point, I have the tweet, and now I've been able to automatically detect if it's positive or negative. So this is a great place for us to now add in an Azure function, because maybe I want to set a category like red, yellow, or green based on the sentiment. So I can go ahead here and add another step. And here I can choose any of my Azure functions to execute on demand. So I'm going to go ahead here and choose an Azure function, which I wrote ahead of time, that will categorize the tweet based on the sentiment score. So the sentiment service will give it a number between 0 and 1, 0 being very negative and 1 being very positive. So I'll actually show you what this Azure function looks like. So this is an Azure function in the portal, and you can see it's very simple. I've just simply had to define my trigger event here, which will be triggered from a logic app. And then I just wrote the simple code. So if the score is below 0.3, it's red. If it's below 0.6, it's yellow, and everything else is green. And just that easily, I've defined the code, and now it will run whenever it needs to.
So what's happening here behind the scenes from a resource allocation and utilization perspective?
Yeah, so resources will be deployed on demand as needed. So I'll actually switch here. There is a function that's been running all day today, and I'll show you how it's running, and it's running pretty heavily. So it's automatically spanned a number of different servers to handle that execution. What's great is that I only defined the code, and these servers have been provisioned and scaled out to meet demands automatically, and I'm only paying for what I use.
And it'll auto-scale as necessary. You don't have to worry about anything infrastructure-related.
Exactly.
And this is what we saw before, C# code, but are the languages supported?
Yeah, so if I create a new function, I can actually choose from a number of different supported languages, like C#, PowerShell, JavaScript. This enables me as a developer to use the language that's best suited for the job. And I can build, deploy, and debug these serverless apps all within Visual Studio.
But now, can you go ahead and visualize the data?
Yeah, exactly. So here I'm going to come back to our serverless app, and I do want to visualize the data that I've generated. So I'm going to add in one more action. And in this case, I'm going to use our Power BI connector to publish this data to a dashboard in real time. Now, while I fill out this step for the Power BI connector, I do want to call out here that I am connected to my Power BI account. And we take security very seriously, so we use Azure Key Vault behind the scenes to securely encrypt and store the credentials needed to authenticate with this service. So whenever OAuth is provided, we always use OAuth, and if OAuth's not available, we use whatever means is most secure.
Because we're connecting to data that's critical to running your business, it's great to see that secure connectivity is just built into the serverless platform.
Yeah, that's right. And as you're connecting to multiple disparate data sources, we want to make that as secure as possible.
So what happens next?
Yeah, so I'll go ahead here and finish pushing this data to the Power BI connector, things like that category that we generated from the Azure function, the location of where the person is tweeting from, and when this tweet was created at. And what's powerful here is now I've created this, and I can simply click Save to publish it, and it will start triggering on those events from Twitter. So I'll go ahead now and switch to this Power BI dashboard, and in just a few seconds, you'll start to watch this dashboard light up as people are tweeting about Microsoft. Those tweets are being processed automatically by our serverless app and scaling up the resources needed to process those requests. Now, if this was during a high time of traffic like Microsoft Build, I have confidence in knowing that my app could automatically scale to meet those demands.
Can we see another app?
Yeah, so I'll actually show you. I've taken an app very similar to this. It starts the same way, but I've added a few more steps. So after I published to Power BI, I've actually added in some logic here so that if somebody tweets a very negative sentiment tweet, I can automatically do something like alert a team using Microsoft Teams or create a case within Dynamics 365 so that my company can be monitoring the customer sentiment and following up with customers on Twitter.
So now the app is deployed. How do we ensure that it's tested and ensure it's running efficiently on an ongoing basis?
Yeah, so this isn't like traditional infrastructure where you can look at processor utilization or other metric. So it all comes to life with a trigger. And as you're building the app, you're running tests to simulate the event, triggers to make sure the app that work in the way that you want. And with that, serverless apps do come with a lot of tracing out of the box. So I can easily see here from right within Azure all of these apps as they're running and understand the data that's being processed. And I get integration with powerful tools like Azure Monitor so that I can view metrics or diagnostics, set things like alerts for if something goes wrong. You saw me show this earlier, but I can use tools like Azure App Insights to understand the health of my app and even integrate with solutions like OMS so that I can do query analytics and understand exactly how my systems are performing against my solution.
So with Azure Serverless offerings, you're getting a fully managed service that scales on demand and run your apps in a fraction of the time. But how do people get started with Azure Serverless?
Yeah, so we have a few quick starts on the Azure Functions and Azure Logic Apps documentation pages. And what's great about serverless is you can spend just an hour or two and have some really powerful apps ready to go. So I'd encourage you to check it out, reach out to us on Twitter if you have any questions, and see what serverless computing and Azure can do for you.
Awesome stuff. Thanks for joining us, Jeff. And don't forget to keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest in tech updates. See you next time.